We have a surprise guest coming up in the 1 o'clock hour. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to leave it at that. Don't want to jinx it. Very exciting. So it's fortuitous that we did come in live on this Black Friday edition. Governor Jesse Ventura is our guest. Governor, the banks are collapsing. I want to get into that. Dubai and deep water as ripples from debt crisis spread globally. We're going to get into dollar hits, 14-year low against the yen, gold above, well, right up at $1,200 right now. But first, let's get into vaccines. I know you've had some personal family experience with that, and perhaps if you'd like, you know, share that with listeners. If not, that's fine. But I have the headlines here out of the Toronto Star, Associated Press, Euro News. Faulty swine flu vaccine withdrawn in Canada after causing thousands of cases of bad reactions. They're admitting in Europe that some of the vaccines have actually been killing people. What's your take on this whole swine flu hysteria?
Well, I haven't been vaccinated, and I won't be. I don't particularly go with that. I don't know. I'm kind of a weird case. I remember when I did Predator down in Mexico, we were down on the set down there for 8 to 10 weeks, and everybody on the set got sick except me. And I asked the doctor, I said, you know, when I was 19 years old, I went to Southeast Asia for a 9-month tour and then an 8-month tour. And I said, whenever you'd arrive over there within 48 hours, you would get so sick that you'd be begging for death. And then it would disappear, and for the rest of the tour, you were fine. And I asked him, this was years later in Mexico when everyone got sick, including Arnold. And I said, doctor, do you think that I've developed kind of an immunity? And I told him my story, and he said, yeah, probably most likely. Now, who knows? I might get the swine flu next week. I don't know. Maybe that's the kiss of death for me. But I don't get vaccines personally because I've really lost a lot of faith in government and my trust in government and what government does. And so, and to me, I that's just me personally. And so I won't get one. And whatever other people do, that's their decision to make.
But the government's been trying to push and order nurses and doctors to take it. The AMA has come out now.
Oh, yeah, no, and I think that's outrageous. Government telling you and forcing you to get vaccines to me is crazy. It should be your choice. But then again, if the choice is the wrong one, then you're responsible. See, I'm a great believer in personal responsibility, which means cutting government out of our lives, and we accept responsibility for our own lives.
I read an AP interview, and I've never even brought this up with you privately, that you believe vaccines hurt somebody in your family?
Yeah, my daughter was injured by vaccines. But she's a rare case. She was born with some problems, and they had mandatory government vaccines that she was required by law to get before she could go to school. And she got she was seizure free. We had controlled them. And then the moment she got the vaccine, she went into a full grand mal seizure that night. And the sad thing is that you can never, ever get any type of compensation for it, because no doctor will get on the stand and say that the vaccine caused it.
Absolutely. Plus, they have
they always have the plausible denial. So, because I had another friend that had happened to their daughter, and he tried to go to court on it, and it cost him thousands of dollars, and he ultimately ended up losing because there's no doctor that'll get on the stand and unequivocally state that the vaccine caused it. But there are cases where it does cause irreparable damage to people, small minority groups of people, and it's treated mostly like collateral damage, cannon fodder, that, oh, well, it's good for the big good of the big picture in most people. If some people get hurt by it, well, so be it. And I don't take that position, Alex, because to me that's like the death penalty. If we put 100 people to death that deserve to die and were guilty, but yet we kill one innocent person, I think that my opinion is that's too big a price to pay for it.
I agree. And once you set that precedent, why not kill 10 innocent people so you can get one bad guy?
Exactly. It's a slippery slope that you go down. And that's the bad thing. So to me, taking these vaccines has to be an individual decision. They should not be ordered by any form of government or anything like that. It should be up to you. If you want to roll the dice and you want to take the chance, you should have the right to do so.
Absolutely. Governor Jesse Ventura is our guest. We're going to come back, talk a little bit more about vaccines, and we're going to get into ClimateGate. Not just the thousands of emails, now the hacked documents, which the police are admitting are accurate, where they talked about fixing the climate models. The computer programs in the code have instructions from the programmers how to carry out the fraud. This is bringing down the man-made global warming hoax.